The universe is a colourful place, yet we are only able to see a tiny fraction of its palette. Light is an electromagnetic wave, and the colour we perceive depends on the wavelength.
Our eyes can see only a tiny fraction of the electromagnetic spectrum.
In a similar fashion, sounds are just vibrations propagating through the air, and vibrations at different wavelengths are perceived by our ears as different tones. Electromagnetic waves and sound waves, they travel through the space-time, but the space-time itself oscillates. These oscillations are called gravitational waves. They have been travelling through the universe since its birth in a broad range of wavelengths, depicting a new palette of colours that we have never seen or heard, so far. How can we measure these waves? Some stars suffer a tremendous explosion called a supernova. The object that remains at the core of the star after the explosion is a compact object, like a neutron star or a black hole. A neutron star can be twice as heavy as the Sun, but with a volume 200 trillion times smaller.
A neutron star is so dense that a teaspoon full of neutron star matter would weigh as much as the whole humanity.
Spinning neutron stars can emit a narrow beam of radio waves. If this beam points towards Earth, what we see is a blinking star in the sky. These objects are called pulsars, and they are the most regular astrophysical objects known. Some of them are even more precise than the best atomic clocks on Earth. Gravitational waves passing through the space between the pulsars and Earth would introduce irregularities in the arrival times of the pulses. By measuring these small variations, we can detect gravitational waves. This is the goal of the Pulsar Timing Array.
We are currently recording pulses with 8 radio telescopes around the globe. 5 in Europe, in Manchester, Westerbork, Effelsberg, Nancy, and Sardinia. 2 in the US, near Greenbank and Arecibo, and 1 in Australia, near Parkes.
But what is producing these gravitational waves? We actually emit them when we move, but they are far too weak to be noticed. To produce strong gravitational waves, you need to deform the space-time in a very violent way. So we need to look into the depths of the universe. During the past billion years, galaxies have been growing by colliding and absorbing other galaxies. At the centre of a galaxy, there is usually a supermassive black hole with a mass billions of times larger than that of the Sun. They're everywhere around us, hidden in most of the galaxies we see, and there's even one inside of our own galaxy. When two galaxies collide, the supermassive black holes inside may be dragged by gravity and friction towards each other until forming a binary. The binary will inspiral while emitting gravitational waves until both black holes merge into one. These waves are the target for the Pulsar Timing Array. Besides the Pulsar Timing Array, there are other experiments currently trying to first detect gravitational waves, like LIGO in the United States and Virgo in Italy. Here, in Hanover, we have a detector called GEO-600.
By using very precise laser interferometric techniques, even beating the limits of quantum mechanics, we are able to measure oscillations in space-time smaller than the size of an atomic nucleus.
In the future, there will also be gravitational wave detectors in space, like LISA.
With LISA, we won't be worried about detecting gravitational waves, but we will be doing gravitational wave astronomy.
We will have new eyes and ears to the universe, and learn about processes that cannot be observed with any other sort of telescope. We will confirm or reject theories of gravity, improve our understanding of black holes, neutron stars, and many other interesting astrophysical systems. We will be able to test our cosmological models to better comprehend the birth, evolution, and the fate of our universe. And who knows what surprises are waiting for us beyond this new window to nature. Gravitational waves will unveil the invisible colours of the universe.